Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you five ways that you can use to clear up space on Windows 10 and Windows 11. The first thing you can do to clear up space on Windows 10 and Windows 11 is to uninstall old and unwanted apps. Whether you're using Windows 10 or Windows 11, right-click on your Start button and then go to Installed Apps or Apps and Features if you're using Windows 10. Now on this list of installed apps on your computer, instead of sorting it by name, you can sort it by size from large to small. And this way you can see which apps are taking up the most space on your computer. For example, CapCut is using more than 1 gig, so I'm going to go ahead and uninstall that by clicking on these three little dots and then clicking on uninstall, and then I'll uninstall this from my computer. I'll just accept this prompt and then I'll uninstall CapCut. So you can imagine if you go ahead and uninstall a bunch of these programs that you don't use anymore, you'll save a lot of space. But in Windows 10 and Windows 11, there is one issue. For example, there are some apps that come bundled with the operating system, and you can't uninstall them using the built-in Windows Uninstaller tools. But luckily, there is a third-party application called Hybrid Uninstaller that'll let you uninstall these Windows apps. And you can get it from this webpage, which I'll have linked in my written guide, which will be the first link in this video's description. So you can go ahead and get it from there. And I always download the portable version. And then I just extract this folder to my downloads folder. And then run the Hybrid Uninstaller portable file. If you do get a smart screen prompt, just click on more info and then on run anyway. Accept the user account control prompts. And here I always choose the second option. Now on the main page, you'll be able to uninstall all of the apps that you're able to uninstall in Windows itself. But to uninstall the apps that come bundled with Windows, you can go to Tools and then Windows Store Apps Manager. And here you have access to uninstall a lot of these apps that come built in with Windows. So in total, there are 52 apps on this list and they're about 1.5 gigabytes in size. And here you can also click on size and that'll sort it by size from the largest to the smallest. And here you can see the Xbox app is using more than 200 megs, for example. So if you go ahead and select a bunch of these Windows apps that you don't use, I'm just going to go ahead and select a few. So here I've selected more than 20 built-in Windows apps to uninstall, and the total size of all of these apps are almost 1 gig in size. So I'm just going to click on Uninstall Selected. Check the box to create a system restore point, and then click on Start. And just to be clear, I'm not saying you should uninstall all of these apps. There might be some of these apps that you actually use. So what you choose to uninstall here actually comes down to personal preference. Once it's finished, you can tick this box to automatically clean up any leftover files and then just click on Scan. And then once it's finished, you can just close the Windows Store Apps Manager. And again, if you go to Tools, Hybrid Uninstaller has a lot of other features that you can also use, which might help you to clear up even more space on Windows 10 and Windows 11. Now, the second way that you can clear up space on Windows 10 and Windows 11 is by searching for and identifying any large files that you have saved on your computer. And the software that I always use for this is WizTree. And you get a lot of software that basically does the same thing as WizTree, but it literally is the fastest disk space analyzer that I've come across. So to get WizTree, you can go to this webpage, and I'll also have this linked in my written guide, and then just click on download. I'll just download the portable file. Once again, open my downloads folder, and then I'll just extract the WizTree executable file to my downloads folder. And then I'll run the WizTree 64 application, accept any prompts. Now the way that you use WizTree is you select the drive that you want to scan. In this example, we're going to use the C drive, and then it'll automatically start scanning the C drive. And then it'll display folders and files on your computer based on their size from largest to smallest. So firstly here we can see the Windows folder is taking most of the space on the C drive. And we can't really go into any of these folders and delete these files. So I'm just going to close that again. And by the way, you can click on this little plus icon to expand the folder to see what's taking up the space. So the next largest folder is the users folder, and then it's my username. And then I see the desktop is using almost 4.5 gigs, and that's due to an ISO file that I have saved there. And I don't actually need that anymore, so I'm going to delete that. So the way I'm going to do that is I'll select this file, and then I'll hold down the Shift key on my keyboard, and then press Delete on the keyboard. And then I'll get this prompt that says, are you sure you want to permanently delete this file? And then I'll click on Yes. And that'll permanently delete the file from my computer. Now in the next folder, I can see that in the downloads folder, there's almost around 3 gigs being used. And then I can expand the downloads folder to see if there's anything that I want to delete in here. But basically you can use WizTree to scan your drive and identify large files that are saved on your computer, which you can either delete or copy to another drive or backup to external media. The third way that you can use to clear up space on Windows 10 and Windows 11 is the Windows built-in disk cleanup. And to access disk cleanup, you can do a search for disk cleanup, and then the disk cleanup app should be the best match, and you can click on that to launch it. Once disk cleanup is open, you can click on clean up system files, and it'll scan your C drive to calculate how much space you'll be able to save. And here you can go ahead and select all of these checkboxes. Under normal circumstances, the Windows Update cleanup can be a few gigs in size, but in this example, it's only a few megs. But just go ahead and select all of these checkboxes, and then you'll see the total amount of disk space you'll gain by running this instance of disk cleanup. So once you're ready, just go ahead and click on OK. You'll be asked if you really want to permanently delete these files. Just go ahead and click on Delete Files, and then disk cleanup will do its thing. The fourth thing that you can do to clear up space on Windows 10 and Windows 11 is by using Storage Sense. And you can access that by doing a search for Storage Sense. And then one of the options should be Turn on Storage Sense. So go ahead and click on that. And then here in Storage, under Storage Sense, you can turn Storage Sense on. But if you click on Storage Sense, you can go ahead and see the advanced options. Here you want to select this option that says keep Windows running smoothly by automatically cleaning up temporary system and app files, and then also turn on automatic user content cleanup. Now here you have some advanced options where you can run Storage Sense during specific times, and I usually set this to every week. And then this option to delete files in your recycle bin, I usually set this to around 14 days. And then next you have this option that says delete files in my downloads folder if they haven't been opened for a certain period of time. And this I usually also set to 14 days. So Storage Sense can help you save space on your computer by automatically doing these tasks in the background. Once you're happy with all of these options, you can also go ahead and click on Run Storage Sense Now. And once it's done, it'll also tell you how much space it was able to free up in this session. The fifth method that you can use to clear up space on Windows 10 and Windows 11 is by moving your user directory files to another drive on your computer. Let's say, for instance, you have Windows installed on a small SSD, but you have another hard drive that has more space. You can go ahead and you can move these user files to your second drive without breaking these links like your desktop, downloads, documents, and so on. And I'm going to link a video on screen now where I show you how to do that, and that'll help you clear up space on the C drive specifically, and also help you if you're someone that regularly formats your computer. I do hope this guide helped you out. Please like the video and go ahead and watch the video that's on screen now to help you clear up even more space on your computer. I'll see you in the next one.